Point. I'm just gonna start focusing on just some small sound bites rather than lengthy videos describing things. I don't think people really care that much, or they don't have the ambition or desire to listen. And I'm annoying. I get it. Let me just explain a couple things. Can I ask you guys a question on camera without being embarrassing? Do you know who the United Nations is? Not much about them? Okay, thank you. Thank you. I'm doing a survey. Thank you. Sir, do you know who the United Nations is? No? Okay, thanks. Here's a couple young ladies I have to ask right here. Can I ask you girls a question on camera without intruding? It's a real simple one. Do you know who the United Nations is?
Yes.
Do you know what their world plans are, what their goals are?
No.
No, okay, thank you. That's all, I'm just doing a survey, thank you. Keep trying.
So I'm gonna just be doing sound bites from now on. I don't think people have the stomach to listen to full conversations anymore about what's going on in the world, nor do I think they really care to listen to me, or do they really care at all. So here's the bottom line. There is no pandemic in the world right now. What there is a UN who needed a leverage device to get a centralized global government started without causing too many ripples, and to get this thing started with people's full approval. How is this done? Very simple, very simple. You create a situation of nonlinear warfare where nobody knows where the front line is. People are scrambling to find safety from the onslaught. You can't find the front lines, so they don't know where to retreat to. If the war is coming from all angles, you're being attacked, and you have nobody to turn to. You have nowhere to run, you have no place to hide, you don't even know where to attack. Because if it's coming on all fronts, which side is your friend, which side is your foe? Are you in the crossfire? Are they all against you? It is very hard to discern. This is how Putin stays in power. By confusing people, confusing his own people, here's a perfect confusion tactic. Put out a bunch of news articles saying that has China attacked India with millimeter microwave weapons. Miss, can I ask you a question on camera, just not to be too intrusive? Do you know who the UN is?
Yeah.
Do you know what their world goals are? Okay, good enough. I'm doing like a survey.
Am I wrong?
Yeah, but it's okay. It's okay.
Something like that?
Yes, not really. They want to get a one world government.
Oh.
Yeah, we're in America. We don't use that. We don't have leaders. We have representatives. Yeah. It's a simple question, you know, and it gives you a lot of information as to how people are. Hello, can I ask you a question? Do you know who the UN is? It's a survey I'm doing.
United Nations?
Yeah. Do you know what their world goals are?
Not really.
Not really. Okay, that's it. I mean, it's not a knock at you either way. I'm just to gain and to show people, because people aren't taught about the UN, and the UN's doing some nasty stuff to us. The only way they could get a world government going, one world government, the only way they could get power to the WHO was with a Category 6 pandemic. How about them apples? You got it, my dear. Thank you. A plandemic. She knew it. Miss, can I ask you a question? Do you know who the UN is? United Nations? You do. Do you know what they're about? Are they good guys or bad guys? She doesn't know. So, one lady says it's a plandemic. I love that lady. I think I'm going to go marry her. Sorry, Sue. I'm just kidding. But no, this is it's a general consensus. You know, you have to try to ask people. Can I ask you guys a question real quick? Do you have masks that you're going to go in with? Do you know who the UN is? United Nations? No, you don't know.
Right here in your very own country of America and the UK and France and wherever you are right now, your leaders or so-called whatever, politicians, whatever you want to call them for your country, if they're leaders or if they're representatives, like we used to have in America, representatives, not leaders. We don't choose leaders in America. We chose representatives we were the leaders. The people are the leader in America, used to be, when we had a constitution. The point is that if you go ahead and say that China is attacking India with microwave millimeter weapons. And everybody gets up in arms. I can't believe this is happening. Let me say this. Your own people at home are attacking your own children with microwave millimeter weapons. 2.4 gigahertz from your cell phone is a weaponized frequency. It's the same frequency they use for the weaponized millimeter weapons. Just off the side there. Now, adding to this propaganda of why it's a pandemic, why wasn't it a nuclear war? Why wasn't it an attack of biochemicals? Why wasn't it an attack from some terrorist faction? Where are the terrorists? Where have they gone? Well, they're an invisible terrorist now called COVID. I'll explain this. The UN had no other way of winning your favor of a one-world government, so they had to use a leverage tool. The only thing that puts all of the world's power into the UN's hands, specifically the WHO, HWO, the World Health Organization's hands, is a Cat 6 pandemic. So a Category 6 pandemic puts all of the world's power into the WHO, which is the UN's watchdog or puppy lapdog. That's the bottom line. So you can think there's a pandemic going on, but if you don't know what the UN's plans were prior to this, which they're all written down in books on paper, they said it in their speeches at General Assemblies. It's no secret. This isn't made up. This isn't my own conjecture. I'm basing my education on 10 years of study, 20 years of studying the UN. I've been studying think tanks and foundations for a long, long time, since 1990s. 1990, we had a little issue with the UN and America. The UN policy has become American policy under the Rio Declaration, which came from the Earth Charter, which is written by a KGB agent and a fascist. This doctrine, this Rio Doctrine Declaration, is rule of law in America right now. It supplants and supersedes American constitutional law. Because, for example, your emissions are checked on your car. They're kept in check by people from the UN. Not from the US, not from Germany, not from anywhere else. From the UN. And it's sent out amongst the rest of the world. You understand? So it has nothing to do with actually what's going on with your car and how it affects the environment. It has to do with a monetary policy that's being re-established, re-rectified, and recreated. It's having to do with an entire system of idiocy that's going on in the world. Now, I'm going to do a short thing outside also. I'm going to ask people if they know who the UN is. Everybody in a mask is. I'm wearing a mask. I'm going to ask them if they know who the UN is. And we're going to see if they do know. And I really don't think they do. But we'll find out now in a couple seconds. I'm right here in front of the mall. And everybody is all, you know, adorned in their gear. And so I'm going to ask these gentlemen coming up if they know. Can I ask you guys a question on camera without, if it's okay? Do you guys know who the UN is and what they're doing with the world right now? The United Nations?
Yeah, I know the United Nations, but I don't know.
You don't know what they're doing?
I'll give you
a hint because I care. Category 6 pandemic is the only way they could get world power. They have written for the past 50 years in their writings that they're looking to gain a one world government. Of course, you've heard of the New World Order and stuff like that. Well, when Bush and everybody was talking about New World Order, he says, we want to try to help the UN reach their goal of the founders of the UN. We want to give them what they want. This was our president was saying this. And he says, we will have a New World Order. Only way they can get power is with a Category 6 pandemic. Go figure. Now they got world power. See how easy that was? Whether it's real or not, it doesn't matter. Do you know who the UN is, ma'am?
Yeah.
You do. Do you know what their goals are?
Yeah.
Do you think it's world peace?
No.
No. Okay, thank you. So there's a couple opinions right there. A woman who understands who the UN is and knows that they're not here for world peace. And a couple gentlemen who know of the world UN but don't really know exactly what's happening. But because of specific ways that we've been treated in our society,
the way that their schooling possibly was, the way that even the highest schooling is. Forget about, let's say, because they're African American and they may have had a poor upbringing or a poorer schooling. I don't know what their life is. They might have grown up in the hills, Beverly Hills, and just moved to Florida. I don't know. The point is that most people's education is deficient, is by default deficient. So nobody knows who the UN is, and I you know, I dare you to ask yourself, do you really know what the UN's about? Now, there's a good book you can read. It's from a gentleman, Nichols, and it's called The UN as a Political Institution. And you should definitely look at that, because the UN is definitely a political party, and they have gained world power now. And so we, as free Americans, as constitutional Americans, that's not what we wanted, is it? We wanted a world government, someone who's not regional, who's someone who's outside of our own community telling us what to do in our communities. Someone who has no idea what it feels like to walk in our shoes is going to tell us how to walk in our shoes. The point of a centralized government and world government is that you don't want somebody who doesn't know you telling you what to do. First of all, I don't know who you are, but I don't want anybody telling me what to do. I govern myself because I'm an educated person who knows how to treat human beings. I know how to treat myself. I know how to take care of my health. I studied a little bit of that, and I tried to pay attention to it. And I try to pay attention to what people, their needs and hopes are and desires in life. So that's where that comes from. And, you know, that's just upbringing. Some of us didn't have upbringing. You can't, not everybody's the same. Point is that even Jefferson made it clear that we need to educate the populace as a whole. Can I ask you a question on camera without being too intrusive? You have a mask, right?
Yeah.
Okay, do you know who the UN is? Oh, you know about the United Nations?
Yeah.
You know that they're there, they're kind of like secretive and not so, okay. Well, the UN, their goal all along, it's been on paper in all their General Assembly meetings, was to gain a one world government, right? That's the new world order, one world government. It doesn't necessarily mean somebody's got a gun in your face, but you can't go out without a mask on. That's a gun in the face in a sense. You know, you're not allowed to do something you don't want to, even if you didn't want to, they won't let you. That's the point. America was never like that before. So now with the one world governance thing, somebody who doesn't wear your shoes, never worn them, is gonna tell you how to live your life from somewhere else in Sweden. Okay, so the point is that the UN needed a leverage tool to do this. Climate change wasn't working for them because the climate doesn't want to play games with global warming and cooling. It doesn't like their game. So I'm a marine biologist. I worked at MOD. I know about that. It's all fake. It's all BS. The point is that climate changes, and if it didn't, we'd all die. Earth needs to change. The mask thing, the pandemic, the UN's only leverage tool to get a one world government in their hands, specifically the WHO, the World Health Organization, a Category 6 pandemic. The only thing that would actually delegate all the world's governance into one little unit was a pandemic. One of their quotes, and I'll leave you on this, is, "We will have a one world government when we have to win the hearts and the minds of the people over." And he says, we're going to do it through crisis creation. We'll create crisis. We're going to win them over by breaking them down. And what will happen is once we get there, he says, we don't care if the crisis is real or one we manufactured. This is all the UN. You can look at climatism.blog, and you're going to get yourself a really good information source, because it's all, the information on the web is just brutal. But thank you so much, because you're helping people understand the scope of what, we're not told in school about the UN. I went to school back in the day, so I was. And I had one good teacher who told me, look up think tanks and foundations, find out their sources. And they all lead up to the same group of people. So they needed a pandemic to create a one world government. It's that simple. The only leverage tool was that, Category 6 pandemic. And they said, whether it's real or not, we don't care, as long as we get it done. Yeah, I just figured I'd share something.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome, my dear. Have a good day. All right. So, folks, I'm just going to leave you on that on the podcast. Check out OTB21 for other podcasts like this. I just try to talk to people, get their opinion. I do a lot of talking to myself. I'm a pain in the neck. I'm annoying. I'm like your worst person on Facebook, because I'm going to make you feel bad, because what I'm going to tell you is not pretty. It's not pleasant. It's real, though. And it's based on years of study. It's not based on conjecture. It's not based on what I got off the news. It's not based off of what I get off of signs and magazines and memes. I've done studies on this for eons. Back in the 90s, I had a professor, Porter Kirkwood. Sir, if you're out there, thank you so much for what you've done for us. And I appreciate you having me look into think tanks and foundations in order to actually
find out the truth behind America and the rest of the world, for that matter. America is just a microcosm in the bigger scope of things. And the idea is, if you could win over the American hearts and minds, the ones who left the other places because of the lack of freedom, and if you can get these people in this country to be less than free, you have won over the world. It's a very simple prospect. So the UN, the UN's who does it, the UN is who's in control of your entire life. And under this whole thing, this is how it happens. How you guys doing?
Good, thanks.
So, you know, folks, just do your best to do your studies, learn about the UN, and you'll find out what's happening. I want to ask these young kids, hey, would you guys mind being in a podcast real quick, just for a second? Would you want to?
Not right now.
Okay, no problem, no problem. Do you guys know who the UN is? The UN? Just
no.
One? You don't know? United Nations?
No.
Okay. And they're all wearing masks. They don't know who the United Nations is at all, and they're wearing masks. There's your answer, folks. Have a good day. Safe travels to you out there, and as they say, Godspeed. I don't know what that is. Is that some kind of new drug? Bonjour. So basically, yeah, it makes me want to listen to Alanis Morissette, you know? I just want to listen to Alanis Morissette, how ironic it is. So that's the trick, folks. It's a matter of just, you know, it's discernment. You got to discern, folks, for yourself, because there's nobody else who's going to do it for you. That's the point of nonlinear warfare, is to send you into a tizzy where you won't have a clue and you won't have a chance to even find the most basic of evidence, of truth, of anything, of logic. And that's what nonlinear warfare does. It makes you absolutely off your kilter. Can I ask you girls a question? Do you know who the UN is?
No.
It's for a podcast. Don't worry. It's nothing weird.
No.
Okay, you don't know. Are you going to put masks on and go in there?
No.
No, I love you. You're awesome. Awesome. Well, let me tell you this. The UN, the only way that they could get their world government into play was with a Category 6 pandemic. Ironic, isn't it? The only thing, not nuclear war, not terrorists, not firecrackers, whatever. a freaking pandemic. So one of the quotes that the UN has from the group called the Club of Rome, that's their little squad, they say that we're going to get these people involved in this one world government through crisis, whether it's real or one that we make up. Go figure. You can put the dots together yourselves. You're smart enough to get it. Go to climatism.blog. You'll find a lot of good stuff on there. And they're really honest people. They're like, they're really there. They're hip. Yeah. See you, girls.
Thank you. Have a good night.
You do the same. And I'm proud of you for not wearing it. Isn't that awesome? Folks, it's real. It's very real. You know, I mean, but you can only ask for so, you know. I'm not even going to bother. She's on a phone, or she's playing on a phone because she knew I was asking questions. So, folks, you see how it works? This is the reality of it, folks. This is the actual reality of it. So, you have a nice day. I wish you the best. I wish you all the safety and joy and glee, everything else you can get out there, because we're in a new scenario here, a new situation. And you know, it's all you can ever do is ask for people to kind of use their minds, and you know, this is security, man. Security force.